Grime is a new Metroidvania platforming Souls-like game that just came out a few weeks back, and it's
pretty good.
If you're a fan of games like Hollow Knight and Blasphemous, then you will absolutely want to play this game. The main character in Grime takes the silent protagonist trope to a new level, as he features a black hole for a head along with a body made of stone. In fact, every character in Grime is made of stone. Enemies early on in the game resemble Eastern Island statues come to life, and they will only become stranger the further you progress. Visually, Grime is stunning. The artwork, animations, background scenery, character design, music, and sound design, it's all a feast for the senses. The small team of devs at Cloverbyte clearly had an extremely unique vision for this game, and they were absolutely able to actualize it and bring it to life. Gameplay is crunchy and satisfying. The way each strike leads to the cracking and shattering of stone really enhances the feeling of combat. And best of all, the parry-counter mechanic parodied from Dark Souls is so unique and satisfying here that I believe it to be the best implementation of counterattack in any Metroidvania Souls-like to date. It's just extremely satisfying to not only succeed with the counterattack, but the fact that your black hole head shatters and absorbs your opponent into your very being never gets old. The big difference between the two games is that upon death, you don't lose a damn thing. While you do lose ardor, but that doesn't matter very much. The more ardor you have, the more mass you collect when defeating an enemy, but it essentially means that death is meaningless, so don't fear the Reaper. Grime also manages to stand on its own in a unique way by providing the player with passive abilities after absorbing a specific number of each enemy type. Once you defeat a mini-boss, you'll be granted a passive upgrade point to use on specific traits for enemies you've fully absorbed. You can then spec or respec these passive abilities each time you grow or level your character at the giant pink bonfire stones. As far as stats go, there's your standard health and focus attributes, along with strength, dexterity, and resonance. Gain mass to level up your character, defeat more enemies to gain more mass, and if you feel like farming enemies before progressing onward, then guess what? Enemies respawn each time you visit a pink bonfire stone, so go nuts trying to max out your character.
Because you will absolutely need to be overpowered before the end.
Also,
since you won't lose mass upon death, make sure to use every single mass pickup as you come across them. There's no reason to hoard these, and you'll need to level up constantly as you progress, so consume away. Grime manages to blend the best of recent Metroidvanias, like the difficulty of Hollow Knight with the eeriness of Blasphemous, and it wraps it up in a nice Souls-like bow. So what's not to like? For me, there were balancing issues throughout, but especially towards the very end of the game. Note that I started playing Grime the day it was released, but that actually gave me a disadvantage. And while the devs did patch a fair amount of issues before I reached the ending, my first run ended up being completely unbalanced and far more difficult than necessary. Even now, after multiple patches, and despite having three attributes to focus on, strength, dexterity, and resonance, only dexterity seems to be a particularly viable build. The faster you can attack, the more likely you are to stunlock your opponent, whereas the strength weapons are all unbelievably slow. Resonant weapons are all lanterns, which don't do direct damage, but prime your next deflect counter to do massive damage. If you're playing through Grime for the first time, I highly recommend going the dex-only route to get familiar with the game, or you will probably be kicking yourself for not doing so by the end. In addition to the balancing issues, you cannot preview what weapons are like to use until you've reached the stats requirement, and for some of them, they're ludicrously high. That means you can spend hours grinding away to start using what appears to be a badass weapon, only to hate its moveset and instantly regret it. Oh, and while you can respec your passive attributes, you cannot respec your primary ones. Level up strength too much, and now you want to go dex? Too bad. You can't exchange those strength points for dex, so grind away some more to level up all over again. If you take my advice and go the dex route, my recommendation is to put the majority of your upgrade points into health and focus for the first half of the game, until you feel like you're no longer a glass cannon when fighting bosses or in combat in general. Grab the Twin Fangs early on and level them up to at least +4. The max is +6, but the mats for the last two upgrades are rare. Then start pumping all of your upgrade points into dex at about the Feaster's Lair, as you'll need to have 26 dex to use the Chisel Nails weapon found in the Carven Palace, which is subsequently the area you'll need to head to after the Vulture Boss. The dex grind for the Chisel Nails will be worth it though, as the special attack for that weapon does double damage for 10 seconds, which, when fully upgraded, will absolutely melt bosses. That's really my only gripe with Grime, as while the gameplay is excellent, satisfying, and challenging, that if you go into this game blind without a plan for your character, that you could either be woefully underleveled by the time you reach the end, and that you'll inadvertently make the game a whole lot more frustrating than it really needs to be. After playing through Grime a second time, I can testify to the fact that the patches added by the devs have made the game far more enjoyable than it was on day one. So if you've been waiting to pick this up, pull the trigger now, because you're certainly good to get started at this point. Those minor issues aside, Grime is still an incredible game, and for $25, it's honestly a no-brainer. While some problems related to balancing and weapon choice could use some polish, the game is far and away an experience worth having, and it is a worthy addition to the ranks of its predecessors. It's for all of these reasons that I give Grime a 9 out of 10. If you enjoyed Hollow Knight and Blasphemous, then you'll absolutely want to give this game a chance. What did you think of Grime? Did you try a strength or resonance build? And how did that go compared to Dex? Let me know down in the comments. And if you like this video, then you can greatly help out my channel by sending those like and subscribe buttons
into an event horizon.
Thanks again for watching.
Take it easy.